So far this morning on the Feather River, the fish are biting lures and swallowing gobs of roe. There's lots of ways to cure roe, but obviously our bait is the right stuff, as we'll end up with 10 salmon today. Now let's go to Raith's house and get a lesson on exactly how he cures his roe for both the Feather and Sacramento rivers.
This is today's roe. You'll take your skein of roe and open it up, make little cuts right down the middle, and then you open it up and you just do a couple little side cuts. Okay, and all you're gonna do is you're flattening it out. You're flattening it out so you can put your dyes on. So we're gonna go with the UV double red dye. So you'll sprinkle that on there like so. You don't have to get crazy with it, but that's quite a bit, and then we'll flip it over and do the other side. Once you're done with that, a little bit more. We're gonna add some slamola. It's a ProCure slamola. It's just another way to get some more bites. Not too much, but just a little bit. Okay, and that right there, it's gonna draw all the juice out of the eggs, and then after, we're gonna put them in the refrigerator after a couple days, it'll go back in, and I'll show you what happens. That's what your roe looks like after a couple days sitting in the refrigerator, it turns all red. Then what you do is you take your roe, you set it on a screen, spread it out. You just let it sit right there for a little while, it'll air dry. You take your roe you just did, you put it in your bucket. You're gonna leave it in the fridge for 2 days. You leave it in the fridge for 2 days, you come back, then you set it on the screen. That's it, so you'll take another one. We're gonna do this again. You take another skein, right down the middle. It's not real hard, it's real easy to do. And then you take your product and sprinkle it on. And we're gonna go both sides. Okay, now this is the double red with UV. This is the slamola. This gives you a little extra, for whatever reason they like it, little slamola, not much. Think of that as your salt, and that's your garlic salt. So then we're gonna use, on this chunk, this is the badass dye. It'll really dye it a deep, you don't need very much of this at all. You barely sprinkle a little of this on. That gives it the super, super dark red color. That's gonna give it the super dark color. And you can just add it in with your other one. It's not gonna hurt. I'm not real particular. You'll take this, cap it off, shake it up, wash your Tupperware off, or get a cardboard piece and put it in an outside refrigerator. 2 days like that. When you get done with that, then you're gonna have this over here. This is the final. You let it air dry. It's gonna look like that. We'll set it right here on top of the other stuff. You'll put it right there. You grab your, this is after 2 days of being in the refrigerator. You go from here, this stage, 2 days in the refrigerator. You hit a little borax on it, rub it around. Okay, there's your eggs now. They're, some people will use them like that, okay? You dry it out, you can handle these now, they won't be all sticky in that. You can handle them, you can use them like that. What I do, I get a paper towel, lay that down like so, take your roe, and just like it came out of the fish, you're gonna lay it, and you'll fold it over. Okay, now that's, after you cut it and everything, you flattened it out, you let all your cures get in there, your slamola, whatever else you like. 2 days in the fridge, then you powder it, then you're gonna roll it back up. And everybody refers to these as burritos. So that goes in a Ziploc bag, goes back in the fridge for 5 days, or in the freezer. You put it in the freezer, what you wanna do is you want the egg to dimple. When the egg dimples, it'll release the juices when you drop it in the water, and when you go to use it to fish it, it'll release the juices. Otherwise, if you leave it like this, you just have round eggs. There's no dimples in there. So that's only 2 days in the fridge. So you're gonna put it in your borax, hit it with that. That'll dry it out where you can handle it, you can work with it a little bit. Get your paper towel. Lay that down. Fold it back up like it came out of the fish. And then there's your burrito. You'll lay that in a Ziploc bag. You'll put those in a Ziploc bag in the fridge for 4 or 5 more days, and then in the freezer. The next day after you freeze it, you can use it. You can fish it, you'll catch fish. It'll work much better for you. But the round eggs are fine. You'll catch fish on this because of the color and the smell. But if you do the extra couple steps, you're gonna catch more fish. If you do just a couple more steps, it's got better smell. It gives it time to break down. The eggs will release all the scent that's, you know, these things are full of all kinds of different scents. I know the bottle's a mess, but that's all right. But you know, it'll go into the egg, it'll give it time to really soak in there, and then it seems to fish much better. That's my cure, that's what I use, that's what I fish, and that's what I have all my confidence in. That's all I do. It's not real hard, it's real easy. You do that, you're gonna catch more fish.